Are the Dallas Mavericks going to be contenders for the 2021 NBA title? What is up, NBA fans? It's Mike here, and that is the question I am going to be answering for you today, at least in my opinion. Alright, how good will the Mavs really be this season behind Luka Doncic? And could they legitimately compete, or even hope to compete, with teams like the Lakers for the title? That's what I'm going to be going over today. I hope you enjoy the video, and let's get right into it. Alright, so looking back at the previous season, Luka Doncic, in his second freaking year in the league, this man's 1 year older than me, and he averaged 29-9-9. Goddamn. Alright, this man is a beast. In my opinion, he just had the best sophomore season since Michael Jordan. I would say the only other player that really compares to him is probably Tim Duncan, who won a title in his second year and a Finals MVP. But I think Michael Jordan's a better comparison because of the offensive game, alright? This man is incredible. 20 years old, 29-9-9, already a top 10 player. Kid's just ridiculous. However, the season did not quite end in a storybook fashion. Porzingis got injured, and the Mavs lost in 6 games to the Clippers, despite Luka Doncic playing absolutely incredibly against the best perimeter defensive team in the league last season, at least when you're looking at the talent they have to guard the perimeter. Alright, he was incredible in that series, specifically considering that he was playing against players like Patrick Beverley, Kawhi Leonard, and Paul George. And as much as Paul George is a meme right now, that's still 3 really dang good perimeter defenders. So, can Luka carry the Mavs to a title this year? Will they be able to improve that much? I'm just going to be straight with y'all, alright? Right now, I don't think he can. I don't think the Mavs are quite there yet. And let me go into why. Alright, you look at their roster for this season. Luka, obviously, going in his 3rd season in the NBA, once again expect him to improve. Kristaps Porzingis is going to be hurt at the start of the year, and assuming he can stay healthy for about 30 seconds this season, which, fingers crossed, because who the heck knows if he will be, he hasn't been healthy for a full season in pretty dang long time. But if he can stay healthy, he's a pretty decent second option. Not a superstar by any stretch, I would say, but he is definitely a solid borderline all-star caliber player, and considering how beastly Luka is, that's definitely enough to get them to the playoffs. Tim Hardaway Jr. had kind of a breakout year last year, 16 points on very good efficiency. He was a very good third option for this team. Trey Burke, they signed for a small contract. He's a very good backup point guard, even if I have my issues with him as a Sixers fan, but that's mostly because other Sixers fans think this man is Jesus himself. Honestly, Sixers fans, chill the fuck out on Trey Burke. He's not that good. He got a fair contract. Anyway, the Mavericks traded for Josh Richardson to the Sixers, ironically, for Seth Curry. I said that backwards, but you know what I mean. Jay Rich is going to be huge for this team, who desperately needs some perimeter defense. And I believe they also have Willie Cauley-Stein on their roster for center. And someone else, they had some other trade. They got James Johnson, who's a pretty solid enough player. You know, he's an energy guy. He's like a tough guy, you know, for their team. So somebody to beat Marcus Morris's ass if he tries to pull some shit on Luka Doncic again. Basically, that's what they got him for, in my opinion. Decent enough player, all right? They've got a solid enough roster. Their defense has improved, trading Curry for Josh Richardson, and I think their shooting's still good enough that it's not really going to be a big deal. I expect Jay Rich to have a very good season, similar to his 2 years ago season with the Miami Heat, where he was very good. Alright, Luka's going to improve. Porzingis, if he stays healthy, is hopefully going to get back to his, like, New York days level. Alright, this could be a very solid team. This is once again going to be a fantastic offensive team, specifically because of Luka Doncic. Alright, this team's going to be beastly. He is going to be beastly. The dude's going to be in the MVP conversation all year. However, I do not believe he's going to win MVP because I just don't think the team is going to have quite enough wins. And I don't think they're going to have enough wins for mainly the same reasons I don't think they're really going to contend. All right, first of all, Porzingis is going to miss the start of the season. We don't know exactly how long into the season he's going to miss, but he is going to miss the start of the season, and then when he comes back, he's probably going to be a little rusty, and then you've just got to sit there and pray to the basketball gods the man doesn't get hurt again a week later, because that seems to be his thing, okay? The dude is as injury-prone as they come, and you know, it's just the sad fact of life. Human beings are not meant to be 7 feet tall. They're certainly not meant to be 7'3". All right, he's probably going to have an injury issue his whole career. You just got to hope that one of these days he can really keep it together long enough for a playoff run. That's what you got to hope. Luka Doncic is going to be amazing. However, he's nowhere near his prime yet, and I just don't know if this man is going to be able to carry the team to enough wins to win an MVP, because even though the roster is all right, it's not really a good enough roster, especially missing Porzingis for up to half the season, presumably. It's not really good enough for them to win and be like a top two seed in the West, because generally that's what you need for an MVP. You need to be a top two seed, all right, in your conference. And I just don't quite think they're going to be there. Same thing for contending. I just don't know if the team's there yet. There are two real issues with this team, all right? Technically three, but the third one's small, and that's that they don't have a ton of depth. But they do have a very solid starting five with Luka, Jay Rich, Hardaway, Porzingis when he's healthy, and whoever the heck they decide to start at center. They don't have a lot of depth on this team. They really don't have much defense on this team. Jay Rich helps with that, but they're still kind of weak on the defensive end. Luka is a little underrated on defense, but he's certainly not great. Tim Hardaway, kind of the same deal, like maybe an average defender. Porzingis is decent enough when he's healthy, but the fact that they try to play him at power forward takes away a little bit of his defensive skills, because he's not like a great perimeter defender. And then whoever they're going to be starting at center, whether that's like Willie Cauley-Stein, not a very good defender, or like Boban, like not a, you know, can't, a bunch of centers who cannot defend in space whatsoever. Trey Burke's going to be their sixth man, terrible defender, all right? This is what I'm saying. This team is really lacking in defense. Josh Richardson is a good defensive player, but he's not good enough to just carry this team to being a good defense. I think the best they can hope for is to be average. They're definitely not going to be one of the top 10 defensive teams in the league next year. And another thing that they really are going to struggle with is playmaking. Luka Doncic averaging 29-9-9 is absolutely incredible, don't get me wrong, but he really shouldn't. Luka Doncic should not be averaging 9 assists a game while scoring 29 points. It's just not good for the team. Someone who is scoring that much should not be having to pass the ball that much. That's too much offensive work for a single player. Okay, no player can do that and also maintain their incredible efficiency unless they're LeBron James. And even LeBron James took a little bit of a scoring backdrop last year when he had his career high in assists. So you see what I'm saying. Luka Doncic, if you look at his field goal percentage, 46% is very nice for a sophomore player taking as many shots as he does. However, he only shoots 32% from three. And you might be thinking, well, we know Luka Doncic is an amazing three-point shooter. Anyone who's seen him play knows he's an amazing three-point shooter. The problem is, he's not getting open looks from teammates. Luka Doncic is not getting these easy catch-and-shoot threes that shooters live off of, okay? He's taking these, like, step-back, off-the-dribble threes with a defender in his face, and that's just not good for efficiency. And Luka is not going to be able, as talented as he is, nothing against Luka Doncic, but as incredibly talented as Luka is, he is not going to be able to shoot great from three until they get another playmaker on this team to help him get some open looks. This man is doing so much work for this team that he can't do it all while also being efficient. He just can't. He's not quite LeBron James. LeBron is really the only player in NBA history who could handle both the main passing load and scoring load for a team and still be efficient. And LeBron James doesn't have nearly as much of his game in the perimeter as Luka does. LeBron is much more of a drive to the basket guy. All right? It's just not sustainable. They need to get another legit playmaker on this team. And before the Trey Burke stands come out, no, Trey Burke is not a legit playmaker. Okay? This man can pass the ball, but, like, he's not an elite playmaker by any means. And also, once again, he's a terrible defender. So, like, Drew Holiday, if I was to name the perfect player for this team, I would say Drew Holiday. Obviously, they can't trade for him from the Bucks, but, like, I'm just saying, they really need that type of player. They could really use someone else in this team to play make and get Luka some open looks. And for right now, He's also just a little too young. You know, in a few years, maybe he'll be good enough to take this roster, because this man's not even remotely close to his prime. Like I said, 20 years old, it's really it's pretty much impossible to imagine just how good this guy can be. He has such a ridiculous amount of potential. But for right now, even though I expect him to improve next season, I just can't see him improving enough, especially considering Porzingis is probably not going to be like a superstar level player because of his stupid injuries. I just can't see Luka doing enough to make this team a contender next year, especially considering how OP the Lakers look right now. The Lakers just won the title and then got better, okay? The Mavericks may have improved slightly, but, like, the Lakers just won the title and then they got better. The Mavs are not going to be able to compete with them in the playoffs. I really think they're about on the same level. Honestly, I don't even think they're quite on the same level as the Clippers, assuming the Clippers can get their chemistry straight. Alright, they need some more defense, and they could desperately use another playmaker on this team. That is what I think the Mavs really need to focus on in this offseason, and if they can get that, if they can just get a little better on defense, and somebody else who's just like a slightly above average playmaker to get Luka some open looks, then this team is a title contender. That's that. But for right now, I just don't think they're quite there yet. So, that is my take on Luka Doncic and his Dallas Mavericks for this upcoming season. Not a contender, but they are going to be a very good, entertaining team, and I'm very excited to see what kind of insane shit Luka Doncic can do this season. I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, please like it and subscribe to my channel. I would really appreciate it, and check out some of my other content. Thank you.